तो 9 चैप्टर 14 टेक्स्ट 40 ऑनवर्ड्स 40 42-49 पुरुरवा प्लीजेस द गंधर्वास एंड लेटर गोज टू गंधर्वलोका बाय परफॉर्मिंग कर्मकांड दैट्स द सेक्शन अंतर्वतनीम उपालक्ष्य देवीम सा प्रययौ पुरीम पुनस्तत्र गतो अवदान्ते उर्वशीम वीरमातरम अंतर्वतनीम प्रेग्नेंट उपालक्ष्य बाय ऑब्जर्विंग देवीम उर्वशी सहा ही किंग पुरुरवा प्रययौ रिटर्न पुरीम टू हिज पैले पुनः अगेन तत्र एट दैट वेरी स्पॉट गतः वेंट अब द अंते एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर उर्वशीम उर्वशी वीर मातरम द मदर ऑफ वन क्षत्रिय सन अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट उर्वशी वॉज प्रेग्नेंट पुरुरवा रिटर्न टू हिज पैलेस एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर देयर एट कुरुक्षेत्र ही अगेन ऑब्टेन्ड द एसोसिएशन ऑफ उर्वशी हु वॉज देन द मदर ऑफ ए हीरोइक सन So he understood she was pregnant because she said she would bear other children. Okay. So Uplabhya Muda Yukta Samubhasa Taya Nisham Athainam Urvashi Kripanam Virahaturam. Uplabhya getting the association Muda in great jubilation, Yukta being united, Samubhasa enjoyed her company in sex, Taya Vidhar Nisham. निशाम दैट नाइट अथा देर आफ्टर एनम एंड टू किंग पुरुरवा उर्वशी द वुमेन नेम्ड उर्वशी प्राह सेड कृपणम टू ही हु वाज पुअर हार्टेड विरह आतुरम अफ्लिक्टेड बाय द थॉट ऑफ सेपरेशन हैविंग रिगेन्ड उर्वशी एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर किंग पुरुरवा वाज मोस्ट जुबिलेंट एंड ही एंजॉयड हर कंपनी इन सेक्स फॉर वन नाइट बट देन ही वॉज वेरी सॉरी एट द थॉट ऑफ सेपरेशन फ्रॉम हर सो उर्वशी स्पोक टू हिम एज फॉलोज So Urvashi, she tried to explain Maharaj Pururava the nature of women so that he will understand. But when she was failed to make understand, then she said that, okay, my dear king, you will be able to enjoy with me as my husband at the end of every year. So once in a year for one night only. In this way, you will have other children, one after another. Okay? So, in this way, Urvashi agreed like that. Okay? So, Maharaj Pururava was very much attached to her and therefore she wanted to give the king some concession. First, she explained the nature of woman so that he will understand. But when she saw that he is not able to understand, then she gave some concession and agreed, okay, I will come to you for one night and I will act like as your wife at the end of every year. So understanding that Urvashi was pregnant, Pururava returned to his palace and at the end of the year, there at Kurukshetra, he again obtained the association of Urvashi after 1 year, who was then the mother of a heroic son. So having regained Urvashi at the end of the year, King Pururava was most jubilant. उपलभ्य मुदा युक्ता समुवासतया निशाम अथैनम उर्वशी प्राह कृपणम विरहातुरम सो हैविंग रिगेन्ड उर्वशी एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर किंग पुरुरवा वाज मोस्ट जुबिलेंट एंड ही एंजॉयड हर कंपनी इन सेक्स फॉर वन नाइट बट देन ही वाज वेरी सॉरी एट द थॉट ऑफ सेपरेशन फ्रॉम हर सो उर्वशी He spoke to him as follows. Now again she is going to speak because he is becoming very sad because she will leave now after one night. Gandharvan upadhavemams dasyanti. Sorry. Gandharvan upadhavemams tubhyam dasyanti mamiti tasya sanstuvatas. तुष्टा अग्निस्थालीं ददुर नृप उर्वशी मन्यमानस्तां सोबुद्ध्यत चरण वने गंधर्वान अंटू द गंधर्वज उपधाव गो टेक शेल्टर इमान दीज तुभ्यम अंटू यू दास्यंती विल डिलीवर माम इति एग्जैक्टली लाइक मी और मी फैक्चुअली तस्य बाई हिम samstuvataha, offering prayers, tushtaha, being satisfied, agnisthalim, a girl produced from fire, duduhu, delivered nirpa, o king, urvashim, urvashi, manyamanaha, thinking, tam har sahahi prurava, abuddhyata, understood factually, charan, while walking vane in the forest. Urvashi said, my dear king, seek shelter of the Gandharvas, for they will be able to deliver me to you again. In accordance with these words, the king satisfied the Gandharvas by prayers. And so she said, if you go to Gandharvas and approach them and request them, and if you can please Gandharvas, they can deliver me to you again. So they can give me, I will be yours fully. So he went. He followed the words of Urvashi and Prurava, the king satisfied the Gandharvas by prayers. And the Gandharvas, being pleased with him, gave him an Agnisthali girl who looked exactly like Urvashi. So they gave him a girl who was exactly like Urvashi. Thinking that the girl was Urvashi, the king began walking with her in the forest. But later he could understand that she was not Urvashi but Agnisthali. She was another girl. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur remarks that Pururava was very lusty. Immediately after getting the Agnisthali girl, he wanted to have sex with her. But during sexual intercourse, he could understand that the girl was Agnisthali, not Urvashi. This indicates that every man attached to a particular woman knows the particular characteristics of that woman during sex life. Thus, Prurava understood during sexual intercourse that the Agnisthali girl was not Urvashi. So he understood. Sthalim nyasyavane gatva grahanadhyayato nishi tretayam sampravrittayam manasi trayavartat. 43, this is okay. Okay, so Sthalim, the woman Agnisthali, Nyasya, immediately giving up Vane in the forest, Gatva, on returning Grahan at home, Adhyayataha, began to meditate Nishi the whole night, Tretayam, when the Treta millennium, Sampravrittayam, was just on the point of beginning. Manasi, in his mind, Trai, the principles of the three Vedas, Avartat, became revealed. King Prurava then left Agnisthali in the forest and returned home, where he meditated all night upon Urvashi. In the course of his meditation, the Treta millennium began, and therefore the principles of the three Vedas, including the process of performing yajna to fulfill fruitive activities, appeared within his heart. Okay, so that's what happened. And now he got the another woman which was like Urvashi, but he understood that she is not Urvashi. So he left her in the forest and came back. Okay, so when he praised the Gandharvas, they were very pleased with Pururava, and they gave him a sacrificial vessel so that he would attain Urvashi by performing a fire sacrifice. So he did a fire sacrifice. But because of complete infatuation with Urvashi, blinded by love, he thought that the vessel was Urvashi. Okay, Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur is telling that they gave him a vessel, okay, to perform yajna, so that he will attain Urvashi by performing fire sacrifice. But because of complete infatuation with Urvashi and so much blinded by love, he thought that the vessel was Urvashi. Wandering in the forest with that vessel, when it came to time for sex, he understood it was not her. Okay, so that is the another explanation given by Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur, that actually they gave him, being pleased with the prayers of Prurava, they gave him a vessel to perform the yajna. But he was thinking this is Urvashi only. So he thought of having sex with that vessel or whatever. Okay, so when it came, so he was thinking that it is Urvashi, so he thought that the vessel was Urvashi. Wandering in the forest with that vessel, when it came to time for sex, he understood it was not Urvashi. okay. So then what he did, so okay, one other thought is here that Vishnachakri Chagu is saying that the warriors were tormented by the lust generated by seeing Rukmani as Maya. Okay, that is from 10th canto 53 chapter. So this resembles Prurava, who became afflicted by lust when he saw Urvashi in the fiery image produced by the Gandharvas. Prurava became lusty not by the fiery image but the thought that it was Urvashi. Okay, so that thought was the cause for lust. Okay, so here the warriors were tormented by the lust generated by seeing Rukmani as Maya. Okay, so Prurava also saw that fiery image or that vessel as Urvashi. So that thing was that Prurava became lusty, how? By not by the fiery image but actually because of the thought of Urvashi. Okay, okay, so King Prurava then he left the Agnisthali in the forest and returned home. So where he meditated all night upon Urvashi, and at that time in the course of his meditation the Treta millennium started, and Treta Yuga, okay, started, and therefore the principles of the three Vedas, including the process of performing yajna to fulfill fruitive activities, appeared within his heart. So when he was meditating that time, this Vedas, the knowledge of the Vedas, principles of the three Vedas, including the process of performing yajna. Because now Treta Yuga is starting, so in Treta Yuga, the Yuga Dharma is performing yajna. So that thing, and this thing, this knowledge is appeared within the heart of Prurava. It is said, Tretayam Yajato Makai. In Treta Yuga, if one performed yajnas, he would get the results of those yajnas. Okay. So, by performing Vishnu Yajna specifically, one could even achieve the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Of course, yajna is intended to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, the only intention behind performing yajna is Krishna's happiness. While Prurava was meditating upon Urvashi, the Treta Yuga began, and therefore, the Vedic yajnas were revealed in his heart. So when he was, that night when he was meditating upon Urvashi, that time only Treta Yuga started. So in his heart, this knowledge of Vedas got revealed. But Prurava was a materialistic man, especially interested in enjoying the senses. So yajnas for enjoyment of the senses are called karmakandiya yajnas. The yajnas which are for the enjoyment of senses, they are called karmakandiya yajnas. So therefore, he decided to perform karma kandi yajnas to fulfill his lusty desires. So in other words, karma kandi yajnas are meant for sensuous persons, whereas yajna should actually be performed to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. To please the Supreme Personality of Godhead, in Kali Yuga, the Sankirtan yajna is recommended. Yajna sankirtana prayai yajanti hi sumedasa. Only those who are very intelligent take to Sankirtan Yajna to fulfill all their desires, material and spiritual, whereas those who are lusty for sense enjoyment perform Karma Kandi Yajnas. Okay. So, while he meditated intensely on Urvashi all night, Treta Yuga started and three Vedas which teach karma manifested. So that three Vedas revealed, and that means whatever the process was for Treta Yuga, that it was revealed in his heart. Okay. Isthali sthanam gato swattham Shami garbham vilakshasaha tena dve arani kritva urvashi loka kamayaya urvashi mantarato dhyayan adharar adhararnim utaram आत्मानम उभयोर मध्ये यत्तत् प्रजननम प्रभु स्थाली स्थानम द प्लेस वेयर अग्निस्थली वॉज लेफ्ट गतहा गोइंग देयर अश्वत्थम एंड अश्वत्थ ट्री शमी गर्भम प्रोड्यूस फ्रॉम द वूम्ब ऑफ द शमी ट्री विलक्ष्य सींग सह ही पुरुरवाद तेन फ्रॉम दैट द्वे टू अरणी पीस ऑफ वुड रिक्वायर्ड फॉर इग्नाइटिंग ए फायर फॉर सैक्रिफाइस कृत्वा मेकिंग उर्वशी लोक कामिया डिजायरिंग टू गो टू द प्लैनेट वेर उर्वशी वेज प्रेजेंट उर्वशी उर्वशी मंत्र बाय चैंटिंग द रिक्वायर्ड मंत्र अध्यायन मेडिटेटिंग अपॉन अधरा लोअर अरणी अरणी वुड उत्तराम एंड द अपर वन आत्मानम हिमसेल्फ उभयो मध्ये इन बिटवीन द टू यत यत दैट विच ही मेडिटेड अपॉन प्रजननम एज अ सून प्रभु द किंग when the process of fruitive yajna became manifest within his heart yajnas karmakanda yajna king pururva went to the some spot where he had left agnisthali he understood that he has to perform a karmakanda yajna to fulfill his senses so he went to the same place where he left the agnisthali there he saw that from the womb of a shami tree an ashwatha tree had grown He then took a piece of wood from that tree and made it into two aranis. Two wooden aranis is called for the firewood which is used for igniting fire for yajna. So he took he saw that from a shami tree an aswatha tree had grown. He then took a piece of wood from that tree and made it into two aranis. Desiring to go to the planet where Urvashi resided, he chanted mantras, meditating upon the lower Arni as Urvashi. So he took two wood, so down the lower wood Arni he thought as Urvashi, the upper one as himself, and the piece of wood between them as his son. Like that he was meditating. In this way he began to ignite a fire. The Vedic fire for performing yajna was not ignited with ordinary matches or similar devices. Rather, the Vedic sacrificial fire was ignited by the aranis on two sacred pieces of wood which produced fire by friction with a third. Such a fire is necessary for the performance of yajna. If successful, a yajna... Okay, so that's what the process they will use. That's how they will... ignite the fire for yajna, not with some matchstick or something. So in this way they will do, and if successful, a yajna will fulfill the desire of its performer. Thus Pururava took advantage of the process of yajna to fulfill his lusty desires. He thought of the lower Arni as Urvashi, the upper one as himself, and the middle one as his son. A relevant Vedic mantra quoted here In Bai Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is Shami Garbhad Agnim Mantra. A similar mantra is Urvashyam Urushi Pururavah. Pururava wanted to have children continuously by the womb of Urvashi. His only ambition was to have sex life with Urvashi and thereby get a son. In other words, he had so much lust in his heart that even while performing yajna, he thought of Urvashi instead of thinking of the master of the yajna, Yageshwar, Lord Vishnu. So he was that much attached. So he went to the place where he left the vessel, a place known as a Chokara. Okay. Seeing an Ashwatha tree going from a cane tree, from the Ashwatha wood he made two kindling sticks and kindled fire. So this Shami Garbhad Agnim Mamatha, from the womb of came Shami tree, he kindled fire. The process of kindling is described, meditating on the lower stick as Urvashi and the upper stick as himself, and the wood between them as his offspring, he kindled. The mantra he chanted begins Urvashyam Urushi Pururava. So that's how he was meditating. तस्य निर्मन्थनाज जातो जातवेदा विभावशुः त्रय्या स विद्यया राज्ञा पुत्रत्वे कल्पितस्त्रिवृत तस्य अपुरवा Nirmantanat, because of interaction, jataha was born, jat vedaha, meant for material enjoyment according to the Vedic principles, vivavasuhu, a fire treya, following the Vedic principles, saha, the fire, vidyaya, by such a process, ragya, by the king, putrutve, a son's being born, kalpitaha, it so become three, vridha, three letters, a, u, om, combined together as om. From Prurava's rubbing of the Aranis came a fire. By such a fire, one can achieve all success in material enjoyment and be purified by seminal birth, initiation, and in the performance of sacrifice, which are invoked by the combined letters Om. Thus, the fire was considered the son of King Prurava. Okay, so that's how he ignited the fire, and that fire is considered as the son of Prurava. According to the Vedic process, one can get a son through semen, Shukra. One can get a bona fide disciple through initiation, Savitra. Or one can get a son or disciple through the fire of sacrifice, Yajna. So these are the three ways to get a son. Thus, when Maharaj Prurava generated the fire by rubbing the Aranis, the fire became his son. Either by semen, by initiation, or by Yajna, one may get a son. The Vedic mantra Omkar or Pranava, consisting of the letters Om, can call each of these three methods into existence. Therefore, the words Nirmanthanaj Jataha indicate that by the rubbing of the Aranis, a son was born. Okay, so from rubbing the sticks together, he produced the fire, which then produced enjoyable objects, Dhanam. And the fire was purified by the knowledge of the three Vedas and was thought of as a son for the king, since it allowed him to go to Swargaloka. Trivritti means the fire in three forms, Ahavaniya, Garhapatya, and Dakshinagni. Okay. Tena yajata yagyesham bhagavantam adokshajam उर्वशी लोकम अन्विच्छन् सर्वदेव मयम हरिम तेना बाय जनरेटिंग सच अ फायर अयजत ही वर्शिप यज्ञ ईशम द मास्टर और एंजॉयर ऑफ द यज्ञ भगवंतम द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडेड अदोक्षजम बियॉन्ड द परसेप्शन ऑफ द सेंसेस उर्वशी लोकम टू द प्लैनेट वेयर उर्वशी वाज स्टेइंग अविच्छन् ऑल्दो डिजायरिंग टू गो सर्वदेव मयम द रिजर्वायर ऑफ ऑल डेमिगॉड्स हरिम द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडेड. By means of that fire, Prurava, who desired to go to the planet where Urvashi resided, performed a sacrifice by which he satisfied the Supreme Personality of Godhead Hari, the enjoyer of the results of sacrifice. Thus he worshipped the Lord who is beyond the perception of the senses and is the reservoir of all the demigods. Okay. So, as stated in Bhagavad Gita, Bhoktaram Yagya Tapsam Sarvalok Maheshwaram, any loka or any planet to which one wants to go is the property of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the enjoyer of the performance of sacrifice. The purpose of Yajna is to satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In this age, as we have explained many times, that Yajna of chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, is the only sacrifice that can satisfy the Supreme Lord. So when the Lord is satisfied, one can fulfill any desire, material or spiritual. Bhagavad Gita also says, Yajnyat Bhavati Parjanyaha, by offering sacrifices to Lord Vishnu, one can have sufficient rainfall. Where there is sufficient rainfall, the earth becomes fit to produce everything. Sarva kama dugha mahi. If one can realize the land properly, if one can utilize the land properly, one can get all the necessities of life from the land, including food, grains, fruits, flowers, and vegetables. Everything one gets for material wealth is produced from the Everything one gets for material wealth is produced from the earth, and therefore it is said, Sarva kama dugha mahi. Everything is possible by performing yajna. Therefore, although Pururava desired something material, he factually performed yajna to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So the Lord is adokshas beyond the perception of Pururava and everyone else. Consequently, some kind of yajna must be performed to fulfill the desire of the living entity. Yajnas can be performed in human society only when society is divided by varnashram dharma into four varnas and four ashramas. Without such a regulative process, no one can perform yajnas. And without the performance of yajnas, no material plans can make human society happy at any time. Everyone should therefore be induced to perform yajnas. In this age of Kali, the yajna recommended is sankirtan, the individual or collective chanting of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. This will bring the fulfillment of all necessities for human society. Okay, so basically the yajna is required and no need to do yajna for everyone but only for Krishna. So just by doing yajna, Krishna is pleased, and when Krishna is pleased, everybody is pleased. And everything is attained by performing yajna. But in Kali Yuga, the yajna is Sankirtan yajna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Okay, so here it is said, Prabhupada is saying that the Lord is adokshaj beyond the perception of Pururava and everyone else. Adokshaj means Krishna cannot be perceived by our material senses. So the Lord is adokshaj. So when we are not able to perceive him by our material senses, then what to do? Some kind of yajna must be performed to fulfill the desire of the living entity. So for that purpose, you have to perform some yajna. And in Kali Yuga, Sankirtan yajna. Okay. So, was the method of karma mentioned in the three Vedas not exactly previously? It was not revealed previously. Okay. So, what was the method? Now, it is mentioned that the method was in the Treta Yuga. As soon as Treta Yuga started, the method was yajna, so it was revealed. So, what was the previous method? Ek eva pura veda pranama sarvavanamaya. एक एव पुरा वेदः प्रणवा सर्ववांगमया देवो नारायणो नान्य एक अग्निर्वर्ण एव च एकः ओनली वन एव इंडीड पुरा फॉर्मली वेदः बुक ऑफ ट्रांसलेटेड नॉलेज प्रणवः ओंकार सर्ववाक्मयः कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ ऑल वैदिक मंत्र देवा द लॉर्ड गॉड नारायणः ओनली नारायण वाज वर्शिपेबल इन द सत्ययुग ना अन्यः नो अदर एकः अग्निः वन डिविजन ओनली फॉर अग्नि Varnaha, order of life, evacha and certainly. In the Satyuga, the first millennium, all the Vedic mantras were included in one mantra, Pranava, the root of all Vedic mantras. In other words, the Atharveda alone was the source of all Vedic knowledge. The Supreme Personality of Godhead Narayan was the only worshipable deity. There was no recommendation for worship of the demigods. Fire was one only, and the only order of life in human society was known as Hamsha. Okay, so that was the situation in the Satyuga. In Satyuga, there was only one Veda, not four. Later, before the beginning of Kali Yuga, this one Veda, the Athar Veda, or some say the Yajur Veda, was divided into four: Sam, Yajur, Rig, and Atharva. So, before Kali Yuga only, this was divided into four. For the facility of human society. In Satyuga, the only mantra was Omkar, Om Tat Sat. The same name Omkar is manifest in the mantra Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Unless one is a Brahmin, one cannot utter Omkar and get the desired result. But in Kali Yuga, almost everyone is a Shudra, unfit for pronouncing the Pranava, Omkar. Therefore, the Shastra have recommended the chanting of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Omkar is mantra or Mahamantra. And Hare Krishna is also a Mahamantra. The purpose of pronouncing Omkar is to address the Supreme Personality of Godhead Vasudeva. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. And the purpose of chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra is the same. Hare, O energy of the Lord Krishna. O Lord Krishna. Hare, O energy of the Lord Rama. O Supreme Lord, O Supreme Enjoyer. The only worshipable Lord is Hari, who is the goal of the Vedas. Vedaischa sarveir aham eva vedyah. By worshipping the demigods, one worships the different parts of the Lord, just as one might water the branches and twigs of a tree. But worshipping Narayan, the all-inclusive Supreme Personality of Godhead, is like pouring water on the root of the tree, thus supplying water to the trunk, branches, twigs, leaves, and so on. So, if you pour the water in the root of the tree, then everywhere it reaches. In Satyuga, people know how to fulfill the necessities of life simply by worshipping Narayan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The same purpose can be served in this age of Kali by the chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. As recommended in the Bhagavatam, Kirtana Deva Krishnasya Mukta Sangha Param Brajet. Simply by chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Simply by chanting this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, one becomes free from the bondage of material existence and thus becomes eligible to return home back to Godhead. Okay, so was the method of karma mentioned in the three Vedas not existing previously? So it was not revealed previously. It was revealed only when the Treta Yuga started. So previously in Satyuga, Om was the seed of all verses. There was one Veda and Narayan was the one deity. There was one fire, not three, and one Varna called Hamsa. Since generally everyone was predominantly in Sattvaguna engaged in meditation. So the only one Varna was Hamsa. So during the first Satyuga in Brahma's day, there was one Veda. Since starting with the Svayambhuva, there are descriptions of different Vedas and Varnas arising. Okay, Pururavas 49. Pururavas eva asit trayi treta mukhe nirpa agnina prajaya raja lokam gandharvam evan. Pururavasaha, from King Pururava, eva das asit, there was trayi, the Vedic principles of karma, jnana and upasana. Treta mukhe, in the beginning of the Treta Yuga, nirpe, O King Parikshit, agnina, simply by generating the fire of sacrifice. Prajaya, by his son, Raja, King Pururava, lokam, to the planet Gandharvam, of the Gandharvas, evan, achieved. O Maharaj Parikshit, at the beginning of Treta Yuga, King Pururava inaugurated a Karma Kanda sacrifice. Thus, Pururava, who considered the yagic fire as yagic fire his son, was able to go to Gandharva Loka as he desired. So, in Satyuga, Lord Narayan was worshipped by meditation. Krite yad dhyayato Vishnu. Indeed, everyone always meditated upon Lord Vishnu, Narayan, and achieved every success by this process of meditation. In the next Yuga, Treta Yuga, the performance of Yajna began. Tretayam Yajato Makhai. Therefore, this verse says, Trai Treta Mukhe. Ritualistic ceremonies are generally called fruitive activities. Srila Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur says that in Treta Yuga, beginning in the Svayambhu Manvantara, ritualistic fruitive activities were similarly manifested from Priyavrata. So in Treta Yuga, beginning in the Svayambhu Manvantara, first Manvantara, ritualistic fruitive activities were similarly manifested from Priyavrata Maharaj. Okay, so thus end the Bhaktivedanta purports of the 9th canto, 14th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled King Pururava Enchanted by Urvashi. Okay. So, at the beginning of Treta Yuga, in Svayambhu Manvantara, the path of karma was started by Pururava starting. It should be understood that the path of karma was introduced at the beginning of each Treta Yuga by the different kings such as Privrata in the cycle of four Yugas. Okay, so every time when Treta Yuga comes, somebody will be, when it starts, some other king, it will be revealed to one of the king, like Priyavrata and all. Okay. Now, chapter 15 is about the Lord Parashuram. Okay, so that chapter 15 we will start tomorrow about Lord Parashuram. Okay, so if you have any question, you can ask. Okay, so now Pururava's descendants will be explained, and their Maharaj, their Lord Parashuram story will come. Okay, Hare Krishna, thank you so much. Shri Prabhupada Ki Jai.